Robert Murphy is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Do you expect those to be approved today? And if so, does that mean we can go to our doctor Monday and get it?
Yes, the crazy system that we have set up looks like it's chugging to the station, and approval is very likely to be today. That could mean really immediate access to boosters for everybody 18 and over with either Moderna or the Pfizer booster.
Some local Illinois school districts want to rely on local COVID metrics rather than a blanket state policy because they say it's different in every part of the state. What are your thoughts about that?
COVID is the same everywhere around the state. The downstate actually is doing worse than upstate. You know, to divide up the policies for preventing COVID by school district is frankly, it's insane. You know, we've got to stick together in this. The cases are going up now. The one in four of the cases are people under 18. You know, this is not a time to fragment our approach. You know, we've got to get over this wave, and you know, then things will loosen up. But we can't have the school districts doing what they want to do.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. Here is the first one. Earlier this week, you mentioned not allowing unvaccinated people at Thanksgiving dinner, but can you explain why the unvaccinated are so dangerous to the vaccinated?
They're dangerous to everybody. They're dangerous to themselves, and they're dangerous to the vaccinated people as well. We know that vaccinated people can get sick. Some of them end up in the hospital, not too many. Some of them can die. It depends if they're immunocompromised. Thanksgiving is usually a multi-generational event. So you've got older people, maybe some people who are sick. It's really just so high risk to put an unvaccinated person into that type of setting. This is just not the year for that. It's very unfortunate. But the unvaccinated people are driving this pandemic. And until the pandemic is over, they really should not be mixing with vaccinated people.
All right, CPS is requiring a two-week quarantine for people traveling to orange states, yet nothing for people who have visitors from orange states. Why is one group penalized and the other not?
This is a great question. this is, you know, public health craziness. This doesn't make any sense. And it's just an example of the whole public health approach that we're taking, that we're, you know, the school district is giving one rule, the county, the city, the state, that state, this state. That's not going to work. This person is correct. It really doesn't make any sense.
All right, here's another question. If someone states their doctor told them they have very high natural immunity, how is natural immunity determined? What testing is done to determine one's natural immunity?
Well, I'm glad the person has high natural immunity. I don't know how they measured it. Probably just a very healthy person who doesn't get sick very often. You're set up for COVID, though. COVID doesn't care about natural immunity. That's the problem with COVID. H1N1 flu is the same. Measles doesn't care, you know, if you're not vaccinated. You know, so it really doesn't really make much difference. Natural immunity is not good enough to prevent COVID.
All right. If you did not get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook.